In this video, we are going to learn about a device or instrument called as vernier caliper. It is an instrument which is used for measurement of length. Now suppose by using our regular scale also we can measure the length or distance. But suppose I have a key and I want to measure the thickness of any of the key in this. So how I can measure? Now I cannot use our normal scale. I have to use an instrument called as vernier caliper. Now we will see in details how the instrument is made and what is its working principle. But in this way we can measure the thickness of a key by using vernier caliper. Now let us understand what this instrument exactly is and how it works. Now this is vernier caliper. It has a scale on which there are markings. Now the unit can be millimeters, inches. In this instrument which I am showing in this video, it is in two units. The bottom one scale is in millimeters and the upside scale is in inches. Now vernier caliper works on the principle of difference between two scales. That means it has another scale and these two scales have some difference in it, and it works on difference between these two scales. So we will see the principle, but prior to that we will see the construction of this equipment. See, this first one and the second one, these are called as jaws. These are used to hold the object. Now for example, if I want to measure the diameter of this pen, I will have to hold the pen between these two jaws. Now in similar way, you can observe here are also there are two jaws. So these are also jaws, but the very basic difference between these two jaws, the bottom one are for measurement of an external feature. For example, if I want to measure the diameter of a pen, I have to hold it like this. And whereas the second one, that is upper side jaws, they are for internal feature measurement. So I will show you later how to measure an internal feature by using a vernier caliper. Then it has a scale, and this scale is called as this scale is called as main scale. As I explained, there are two scales. The first one is called as a main scale, and the second one, what you can observe here on a movable part, this one is a movable part. And on movable part, whatever scale you observe, that scale is called as vernier scale. The part on which this scale is engraved is called as a main body of the vernier. Then the second, the movable part which can move, it is having a jaw on which there is a vernier scale, is having a lock nut by using which you can restrict its movement and lock the dimension. So now one more thing you can observe here, if I move this jaw, here is a rod, and this is used for measurement of depth. We will see how, but this rod is called as depth measurement bar. So it is a depth measurement bar or rod, you can call according to your convenience. Then let us see now how to measure something by using vernier caliper. Now see, I want to measure the thickness of a key. So how to measure this? I will have to hold the key in one hand and then I will put it in the jaws of vernier caliper, which measures the external dimension, and I will have to hold it like this. Now there is a lock nut by which I can lock the dimension. So I have locked the dimension and now I can remove the key. Now once the key is removed, we have to now take the reading. Now how to take the reading? I will write the formula. Later I will explain how that formula comes. That is total reading is equal to, we have to read two scales. There is a main scale, as I explained earlier, So this is a main scale reading, plus there is a vernier scale, and on vernier scale there are number of divisions. So there is a vernier scale division. I will explain what exactly is mean by vernier scale division. Into there is a parameter which is called as a LC, that is a least count. So this is the way by which we can measure the reading, that is a main scale reading plus vernier scale division into least count. Now let us understand what exactly this main scale reading, vernier scale division and least count, these things are exactly. Basically, least count is the value of the measurement, what is the smallest value that can be measured by an instrument. For example, if you take a normal scale, a plastic scale that you use in your school or college, how much minimum value it can measure? It is 1 millimeter. So that 1 millimeter is the least count of that particular scale. So least count means it is the smallest reading that can be measured by an instrument. Now let us see what is the principle of working of vernier caliper. You can observe here, I will remove this lock and then let us observe this. There are markings on main scale and they are in millimeters. Now if I consider this, this is a zero of main scale, and from this 0 to 49, you can observe here 49 millimeter, 1 division equals to 1 millimeter. So this is the 49 millimeter distance. This 49 millimeter distance is divided into 49 parts. So I will write here on main scale there are 49 divisions in 49 millimeter. So 1 division is equal to 1 millimeters. Now observe, there is one more scale which I am showing here. This is the vernier scale. On vernier scale the distance is same, that is 49 mm. But now here you have to observe how many divisions are made. Between these 0 to 1 there are 5 divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 divisions are there between 0 to 1. So in 10 numbers there will be 50 divisions. So 49 millimeter distance is divided into 50 divisions. So on vernier scale 50 divisions in 49 millimeters. So 1 division on this vernier scale, how I can find out? It is 49 divided by 50, it will come to 0.98 millimeter. That means 1 division on main scale is of 1 millimeter and 1 division on vernier scale is of 0.98 millimeters. If you observe here, the first division on main scale and first division on vernier scale, they are of unequal length. The first division on main scale is 1 millimeter distance and first division on vernier scale is 0.98 millimeter distance. So if I want to make a first line of vernier scale to coincide with first line of, that is 1 millimeter line of main scale, I will have to move this jaw by how much distance? It is the difference between these two. So difference between two scales, difference is 1 millimeter minus 0.98 millimeter. So that comes to 0.02 millimeter. That means even if this movable jaw, if it is displaced by 0.02 millimeters, the first division on vernier scale will coincide with first division on main scale. Now let us see, if I consider this 2 millimeter division. So 2 divisions on main scale, 2 divisions equal to 2 millimeter on main scale, and 2 divisions on vernier scale equal to how much?
it is 0.98 into 2. So it will come around 1.96. So the difference between these two will be 0.04. That means if I want to coincide this second division of vernier scale with second division on main scale, I will have to move this jaw by a distance 0.04. Now see, this is the smallest distance that we can measure. In the same way, as we go further, for further divisions, the difference will change by 0.02 multiplied by the division which is there on main scale, vernier scale. So that is why this formula comes. Now suppose I will set some reading here. I will set some reading here. For example, say right now I have set 10 millimeter plus some distance. So how to read this? So see here, 0 of main scale, it crosses 10 millimeter distance. Now we can surely say that right now the distance is 10 millimeter. But beyond that 10 millimeter, we don't know how much it is. So how to find it out? So after that, we know that if first division of main vernier scale matches with the division of main scale, it has moved 0.02 mm. If it is matching with second division, it has moved with 0.04 mm. Similarly, now I have to find out which division on vernier scale matches with which division on main scale. So if I observe here, I will have to see in a perpendicular direction now. So which division is matching, I have to check here. Now for example, say 1st, 2nd, 5th, 10th. Okay, see here, this is the division indicating 4 number. So actually this is not 4th division. In 0 to 1 there are 5 divisions. That means in 0 to 4 there are how many? 20 division. That means 20th division is coinciding with the main scale division. So how I can measure? 10 millimeter is my main scale reading, and beyond 10, how much it has moved, how that we can find it out? That is a coinciding division multiplied by 0.02 that we calculated earlier. That means a 20th division into 0.02 will give you the final reading. So it will come to 10.40 millimeters. So this is the way how we have to use vernier caliper. In next video we will see how to measure the inside dimension. Now we have just seen the concept for millimeter and the vernier scale, which also gives the reading in millimeters only. Now the upper part will give you in inches, but the concept remains same. By using this instrument you can measure outside features, internal features, as well as depth if you want to measure. Then such vernier principle is required to measure less than what our normal instrument can measure. For example, our normal scale can measure up to 1 millimeter only, but if I want to measure less than 1 millimeter, I will have to use the vernier instrument, which utilizes the principle of two scales, as I explained. Thank you. We will meet in next video.